always a good one when you come back to Asbury Park. And you guys make us feel right at home. We're from all over the world, actually. But there's no place like home, you know. You got us right here. Is there any horn players in the house still? Any horn players still in the house? If you got a horn, feel free to bring it up. Open auditions tonight. Well, I guess you're stuck with me then. We all need a little bit of hope sometimes. We all need a little bit of hope sometimes. So this is a song for us. A song for hope.
Thank you.
you don't mind, get up for my band one more time. They're fantastic. Great night, it's been an incredible evening.
We love you!
Gotta love my house tonight. You know, my dad used to live in Asbury back in the 60s. And he was one of those people in 1967, I believe. A lot going on in the country, and it was weird times here, and you know, the Vietnam War was happening, and people were getting drafted. My dad decided that, you know, while he was living here, he decided that he didn't want to be drafted. So instead of being drafted, he enlisted. He decided that he didn't want to go into any other branch of military but the Marine Corps. So, all that to say, my dad and I are a lot different from each other. I've always been thankful for his service and thankful for his heart for the country. And he taught me a lot about that. Which is beautiful in itself, and I'm grateful. I grew up on military bases, and I've seen lots of different shades of America, if you will. But you know, my dad and I were a lot different from each other, and I had a hard time as a kid, you know, watching my dad, because he had these struggles that he dealt with, these inner demons that he wrestled. He was a man who was born in the South, a black man in Southern Virginia.
God bless.
And which is immediately was a hard thing at the time. Still is in some places. And strict Southern Baptist, military vet, and. Because I'd hear my dad talk about things he believed in, and then I would see him come home at the end of the day with a different story. I wasn't familiar with the things he spoke about. It was a... You see, he had these struggles. There's this man he wanted to be. There's a person he wanted to be, that he believed in. But he had a hard time being that person. And there's lots of reasons for it. And I used to be so bitter as a kid, watching my dad say one thing and do another thing. I used to be so bitter just watching my dad leave the house in the morning with hope in his eyes and come back broken. And as I got older, I started to understand a few things. And beyond my bitterness, I started to understand that my dad was teaching me something beautiful through his own example, something that cannot be taken for granted, and something that is hard to do. You see, because my dad looked in the mirror every morning with hope in his eyes, believing in something, and he failed often. And the next morning, he woke up again with open his eyes and a commitment, trying. And then he failed. But my dad never stopped trying. Some levels of perseverance that are hard to be taught. but I'm eternally grateful to my Father for that incredible lesson he's given me about never giving up. Never giving up, no matter how many battles you lose, no matter how many times you fall down. Never give up. This is for my Pa. An apple from a tree, you know you're hungrier than ever before. You say you saw a victory, but you're losing it too. Your temptation shines. You say you're prayer, you're gonna need it. Separates you from the love you want so. You give it all you've got and now you'll give even more to reach your goals. Say your prayers, you're gonna need them. Sometimes just need a little bit of help from your friends, you know? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah! from my friends, a little help from my friends. I feel like I could use a doctor. That's right, actually. Matter of fact, I feel like is there a doctor in the house?
Yeah.
I was just joking. Before we get to the doctor part, tell you what. If I could just ask my band here, ever so kindly, to give me a nice big solid G chord. One I can feel, one that the people could feel. But I need it. That nice big G chord, I need that thing. One time, just one time. Give it to me right. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Give it to me two times, come on now. Yeah! You know what? Let's take that up a notch. Take it up a step and give it to me. Give it to me five times. That thing up a notch. Take it up one more step. That's right. And give it to me. Seven times. Give it to me 11 times! Some of that good. Good.